When you're ready to edit your config, press the Edit button. These are all the settings for my config. The name of my config, the color I want my Zim to display when the config is loaded. For example, as I change the color, notice how my XIM4 changes. This real-time update happens for all the settings, so it's very easy to configure your device. The hotkey for your config. This is the button you want to press in order to load this particular config. If you don't want to set one, you can simply use your XIM4 manager to load your config. Next, mouse settings, which controls your aim, keyboard, which controls your movement digitally, joystick, if you're using a game board, controls move it, analog, finally, buttons, which are actions in the game, for example, fire, aim down sight, melee, and so on. First, we're going to adjust mouse settings. There's only one setting, sensitivity, so it's very simple. All you need to do is press the plus and minus and try out the setting. Keep doing so to hit your preferred setting. Next, actions. Notice I have my mouse bound to fire and aim down sight, but I like to make a change for my reload. All you need to do is press on it. It says listening, and then press the button you want to change it to. Now, when I press it, it reloads. For example, again, change weapons. Listening, press the button, now it's bound. My Zim was automatically updated. Press the button, it changes. Keep doing so until you've updated all your bindings and all your settings until it feels right for you. Because I'm using a game board, movement is analog for me. I can simply use the stick and movement occurs. If I'm using a keyboard, make sure to set your keyboard keys for up, down, left, and right. There's also a walk modifier as well. Reload. Change weapon. Aim down sight. When you're done editing your config, simply press the save button. And then you're done. A config can have multiple mouse, keyboard, and button settings that can be switched by pressing a button you choose. You can have up to 6 different settings per config. Scroll right and left to view them. For example, here we have hip, aim down sight, and 4 more that are not currently in use, but are available for things like turrets and vehicles. Let's go back to hip. The most common use of settings is for changing behavior when switching between hip and aim down sight aiming in game. Games typically have different aiming characteristics when you aim down sight, so XIM4 uses a different smart translator specialized for this mode. All settings, except for hip, have an activation section. For ADS, set the activation key to what you use to aim down sight. When you aim down sight in game, the ADS settings on your XIM4 will activate. Notice how mine is set to right. And we have aim down sight set to right. So when you aim down sight in game, it'll cause settings to switch to aim down sight. Notice the colors of the settings. Yellow, green, red, and so on. To make it easier to know you have things set up correctly, XIM flashes whenever a settings change. For example, if I aim down sight, it flashes green. When I release and it goes back to hip, it flashes yellow. Again, green, yellow. In the HUD, you'll see it as well. Aim down sight, activated. Hip activated. Aim down sight, hip. Notice how we're missing keyboard, joystick, and buttons within the aim down sight settings. This is because we've chosen to inherit all button settings from primary, which is hip. In general, This is what you'll typically have for all your settings. But if you wanted to customize buttons, simply uncheck Inheritance. In this case, we'll keep it on. An advanced feature of settings is a delay. In some games, like Call of Duty, when you aim down sight, there is a slight delay between switch from hip to aim down sight. In order to compensate for that, a delay is available in this settings. All console shooters have different aiming turret speed limits. Smart translators are designed to provide the gamer with one-to-one connection between the mouse and aiming reticle on screen up to that speed limit. To help tune your settings, XIM4 provides an exceeded maximum turn speed notification in the form of a quickly blinking red light. If you see that light, it means you're moving your mouse faster than the game can turn and you may feel it. For example, here I'm turning and I'm not seeing any notification, but if I go a lot faster, notice my XIM flashing red. It's warning me that I've exceeded my turn speed limit. Use this notification to adjust your sensitivity on your mouse to your preferred setting. If you no longer prefer to see the notification, simply edit. Tap the three dots, and here you can turn off your turn speed exceeded notification, as well as the notifications you see whenever you switch settings, the yellow light and the green light.